सिंगल पार्टिकल टनलिंग एंड सुपर टनलिंग टनलिंग रिसेप्शन इफेक्ट इट इंक्लूड्स एसटीएम डीसी रिसेप्शन इफेक्ट ब्लॉक्स क्वांटाइजेशन देन कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ स्क्विज देन टाइप एंड एप्लीकेशन एंड रिसेप्शन इंट्रोडक्शन स्क्विज स्टैंड्स फॉर सुपर कंडक्टिंग क्वांटम इंटरफेरेंस डिवाइस इट वर्क्स ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ रिसेप्शन जंक्शन When superconductors are separated with a thin insulating layer that is 10^-9 shooting layer 10^-9 meter, then this element is called Josephson junction. Squid is a very sensitive magnetometer used to measure extremely subtle magnetic field based on superconducting loops containing Josephson junction. It is of two types, RF squid and DC squid. To understand squid, we need to learn its the terminology used in it.
Which one is it? Okay, right.
This is the representation of how precisely a squid can measure magnetic field. There are various magnetic field intensity we encounter in our world. Refrigerator, hardscape, urban noise, human heart, human brain can produce 10^-2, 10^-4, 10^-7 respectively. But squid can detect 10^ very small amount of magnetic field that is around 10^-15 tesla. Now we are learning the terms used in it, superconductivity. The phenomena in which the electrical resistance of a given specimen of metal or alloys suddenly turns to zero on cooling it to extremely low temperature is called superconductivity. The temperature at which the resistance of the specimen becomes zero and it enters in superconducting state is called critical temperature or transition temperature. Here the graph is plotted between resistivity and the temperature. TC is the transition temperature here. As we rise the temperature, the resistivity also increases for normal metal. For most of the metals, as we rise the temperature, the resistivity also increases. But after reaching a certain value of temperature, the resistivity is virtually zero. This first superconductivity was found on mercury. This type of phenomenon is showed by different elements like lead, tin, and mercury. This phenomenon is called superconductivity. The materials which showing this effect is called superconductors. High temperature, high magnetic field, or high current density vanish this property. Superconductivity are perfect diamagnetic materials, that is, they are repelled by magnetic fields. 28 metals display superconductivity and usually it is occurring at temperature less than about 10 Kelvin. The temperature which we need is very low. It is around 10 Kelvin or 20 Kelvin cooper pair. the three electrons inside superconductor that are attractively bound, it's called Cooper pair. Here the Cooper pair is moving inside a lattice. They are formed by electron phonon electron interaction. An electron in the cation lattice will disturb the lattice around it. As we saw, the electron is forming. If we consider this part, the electron is forming and the lattice, the point, the lattice are squeezed. When the electron is there, as the lattice are cations and electrons are and electrons are negatively charged, so they both attract and interaction, creating a area of greater positive charge around charge density around itself. Single particle tunneling and Josephson tunneling. Single particle tunneling, consider two metals separated by an insulator. The insulator normally acts as a barrier to the flow of conduction electron. From the metal, from one metal to the other. If the barrier is sufficiently thin, less than 10 or 20 angstrom, there is a significant probability that that the electron which strikes the barrier will pass from metal to the other, one metal to the other, through insulating layer. Josephson tunneling. Under suitable condition, the tunneling of superconducting electrons, electron pair from a superconductor through a layer of insulator into another superconductor. Such a junction is called weak link. Superconductor, insulator, this is the insulator and superconductor. This is called weak link. The effect of pair tunneling include AC Josephson effect and DC Josephson effect. Josephson effect. The phenomenon of flowing electron or current from first superconductor to the second superconductor through an insulating layer is called Josephson effect. It is of two types, AC and DC. Josephson effect has two or more superconductors along with a weak link. To understand it, we are going to know it, we are going to understand it by comparing. When two superconducting materials are separated by an insulator of very few thickness and are connected by a wire, a DC current flows in the external circuit and it's called DC Josephson effect. Here, here it is the DC Josephson effect. Here no external field is, no external current is applied, current or voltage is applied, but electron from the first superconductor flow from first superconductor to the second superconductor through the insulating layer. And the current persists for a, in DC Josephson effect, the current persists for a longer time and is given by I equal to IC sin phi t minus phi 1. AC Josephson effect. When two superconducting materials are separated by a very few thickness and are connected to a DC power. Here no current supply is there, and in AC there is a current supply, voltage supply. Then AC microwaves are produced at the junction, and this effect is called AC Josephson effect. The current persists only for a shorter time and is given by I equal to IC sin phi naught plus 4 pi e t by h. Here h is Planck's constant, b is voltage across the junction. Phi 2 minus phi 1 is the phase difference between the two junction, and IC is the maximum current. That depends on the geometry of the junction, shape of the operating temperature, and the Josephson, the phase is a phase difference resolving across the insulator itself, which always stays same. It is time independent. While in AC Josephson effect, this effect is mainly proving that the Josephson junction can also act as an accurate voltage to frequency converter. It is time dependent. फ्लक्स क्वांटाइजेशन इज ए क्वांटम फेनोमेनन इन विच द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज क्वांटाइज्ड इन द यूनिट ऑफ एच बाय टू ई ऑल्सो नोन प्रीवियसली एज फ्लक्स क्वांटा और फ्लक्स वाइज फाई इक्वल टू एन एच बाय टू ई फेर एन इज एन इज इंटीग्रल मल्टीपल एन इज फेर फ्लक्स क्वांटाइजेशन इक्वल टू फाई इक्वल टू इंटीग्रल मल्टीपल ऑफ फाई नॉट इज एच बाय टू ई विच इज इक्वल टू 2.0679 इंटू 10^-15 स्क्वायर बार. If we place a metallic ring in the magnetic field, the magnetic lines of force are processed through it when the temperature is greater than critical temperature. But when the temperature is less than critical temperature, it does not allow the magnetic lines of force to pass through it. Construction of squibs. It consists of two superconducting rings. It is a half ring and it is another half ring having magnetic field placed in between two Josephson effect. It is a superconductor insulator and superconductor. So it is a Josephson effect and it is another Josephson junction. Squids are usually fabricated from either a lead alloy with 10% gold or indium and or neodymium. More recently developed high temperature squids are made of substances called YTCO. When magnetic field is applied, there is a phase difference at two junctions. So the interference between two phase happens and results in the change of Josephson current as magnetic field is changed. When current enters from this terminal, it divided into current arises and it divides into two parts. Then it flows through the insulator and it interferes occurs. And we know from the Kirchhoff's current law, amount of current entering is equal to the amount of current leaving. So here interference, here division occurs and here interference occurs. So it is a quantum interference, superconducting quantum interference device. Squid is of two types, RF squid and this is squid. It contains only one Josephson junction. RF transfers radio frequency. It is less sensitive than the DC squid. It can be used as a magnetic field detector, but it is easier and cheaper to manufacture than DC squid. Larger noise compared to the DC squid. In RF squid, one junction superconducting loops would look coupled to the circuit driven by RF current source. That is, the loop would experience the flux produced by the current higher RF. This is good. It contains two parallel Josephson junctions, and this is superconductor, insulator layer and superconductor. It is used to measure the magnetic field. One of the most promising use care of is even magnetocephalography. It is not cheap, neither easy to manufacture compared to RF squid. It is very sensitive and can detect even a minute change. Application of squids. Used to measure arc magnetic field, it can detect weak magnetic field produced by biological current like human brain, detection of iron deposition in human liver, used in cardiology for magnetic field imaging, detectors to perform MRIs in geological purpose, to detect mineral ores and oil, in ocean to detect submarine and sea communication. Superconductivity is such a fascinating topic. Here six scientists have honored with Nobel Prize. For the first time, Kamerlin owns in 1913 her properties of material at low temperature, that is mercury. He discovered it for mercury and so it in other materials. These are my references. Thank you.